Good afternoon, Don and Ida, those online, and everyone here today. We'd like to welcome to the West Point Band concert under the direction of our commander, Lieutenant Colonel Todd A. Addison. I please now invite you to rise and join in the singing of our national anthem.
Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to today's performance by the West Point Band. We will now perform a movement from a piece that established William Grant Still's reputation worldwide as the first symphony by a black composer to be performed by a major orchestra. It also features a unique instrument, the banjo, as played by Sergeant Major Brian Roman. This is Movement 3, Animato, from the Afro-American Symphony by William Grant Still. Thank you. Originally from Buenos Aires, the composer of our next piece has spent most of his life at the intersection of the distinct worlds of classical, jazz, rock, and Latin American music. New York-based award-winning composer, arranger, pianist, and music producer, Daniel Freiberg, composed his Latin American Chronicles Concerto for Clarinet and Symphony Orchestra in 2015. This major work fuses the distinct worlds of classical, jazz, and South American folk music. Please welcome to the stage our featured soloist for Daniel Freiberg's Latin American Chronicles, West Point Band Principal Clarinet, Sergeant First Class, Kristen Mather de Andrade. West Point has long been a champion of works for wind band, with commissions from the Academy's sesquicentennial and bicentennial, producing staples of the repertoire that have all one thing in common: high art, communicating the experience and values of West Point's historic long gray line. Continuing in the great tradition of commissioning fine works, we are pleased to present the world premiere of Symphony No. 2, West Point, by award-winning composer Brooke Pierson. We are delighted that Mr. Pierson could join us this afternoon. So at this time, I'd like to welcome him to the stage to say a few words about his piece.
Good afternoon. I'd like to first thank the West Point Band and Lieutenant Colonel Addison for welcoming me here today. I'm privileged to be standing among some of the best musicians in the world and to share a moment in time with them, which will undoubtedly be a memory of a lifetime for me to cherish. In February of 2020, I came here for the first time to hear the band perform my tuba concerto, and I was profoundly impacted by the history, culture, and surrounding landscape of this community. Members of the band gave my wife and I tours of the grounds, visiting important places and watching some daily traditions be undertaken. It also didn't hurt that our winter visit back then, it was 62 degrees, sunny, and we were able to hike in the middle of winter, so that was great. The experience left a deep and lasting impression. When I was asked to write my second symphony, I knew right away that I wanted the work to celebrate the tradition and honor of West Point, and also the beauty of its geographic location. While writing this in the spring of 2021, I also recognize the vastly different environment our nation has been placed in due to uncertainty and challenge and social-emotional upheaval from the COVID-19 pandemic. It was clear to me that music such as this needed to bring joy, a sense of positivism and unity. American composers who I admire, such as Aaron Copland, were especially critical in developing the American sound of our musical history. And the Second Symphony is my interpretation and addition to that American sound. As luck or serendipity would have it, standing on stage here is the first time I've made a trip for a premiere or gone anywhere requiring a plane since February of 2020 when I was last here at West Point. West Point has become an inflection point in my life, and I could not be more grateful. Before I turn it over to the band, I wanted to say what a privilege and honor it is to be standing before you all here and at home, and to have been given the opportunity to share my music with the world. The scope of this opportunity and the stage it is set on is one of the most significant honors of my lifetime, and I want to thank the band and Lieutenant Colonel Addison for entrusting me with this work. Thank you.
Thank you.
Please welcome back to the stage the voice of the Hudson Valley, Sergeant Major Mary Kay Messenger, as she sings Breezy Song, the Golden Globe Award winner for Best Original Song from the 1973 film Breezy.
studied all the pictures in magazines and books. I memorized the subway map too. It's one block north to Macy's and two to Brothers Brooks. Manhattan, I prepared for you. You certainly are different from what they have back home, where nothing's over three stories high, and no one's in a hurry or wants to roam. But I do, though they wonder why. They said I would soon be good and lonely. They said ticket home in my pocket to do with as I choose. Burn the bridge, bet the star, baby's coming home. Not for the life of me. Break the lock, post my bail, done my time. Give me.